1890, we are going to listen to Hazel Hedrick, one of five daughters of Wilson N. Showalter.
There on the Locust Street on the south side, they were all frame buildings originally, and they were owned by the first John Hedrick. And there was a big fire down at the time, and you know, all those buildings were burned. And so when they were replaced, why, the present buildings went there now, and they're made of brick. Well, I was born in 1887, and our home was down there on Locust Street, right next to Father's store. And
your father was?
My father was, he and his father, my grandfather, were in business together. They had a furniture store, and he was an undertaker, and he got a state license as an embalmer. Oh, yes. Just back of our home, well, let's go down the alley past the furniture store, but and there was a livery barn. There weren't any automobiles at that time, and father had a team of horses that he used to drive to his hearses. And it was a beautiful team of dapple grays. And he kept them there at the livery barn. And so when he'd have a funeral or occasion to use them, I'd someone from the livery barn would drive them.
Hazel's father, W.N. Showalter, had a furniture store next to his home. As we see Hazel and her sisters play in their backyard, which today, in 1986, would be the parking lot next to the gazebo park across from the town library on Locust Street.
And Billy Brown had a blacksmith shop down there, and down the alley, and we used to go down there and watch him shoe the horses. And in the summertime, when flies were bad, we got to shoe the flies off the horses, and it was something made out of a horse tail that you just switched around to keep the flies off.
Hazel attended Central School, built in 1888 on Columbia Avenue between 7th and 8th Street. In 1901, W.N. Showalter purchased a steam-powered locomobile. Hazel is standing in front. W.N. Showalter later moved his family from downtown to this home on the southeast corner of 6th and Columbia. Thank you. Clinton Hess built this home at 248 North 6th Street, and his son Raymond married Alpha Showalter, Hazel's sister, and lived here. This is one of the earlier homes built in Middletown on North 5th Street, across the street from this house on the northwest corner of 5th and High Street, which was built by L.O. Miller in 1899 for Hazel's father-in-law, John Hedrick II. And this is Mrs. John Hedrick sitting in her new home. Visits from Nebraska. Hazel's son Nelson and daughter Dorothy sit on the hood of the automobile.
Friend of mine, Avis Kelly, and we came up Fifth Street, and they were building the Hedrick house then, and I saw Jim Hedrick and some boys sitting in the top of it. It didn't have any top on it yet, didn't have any roof on it, and that's all my memories about that house. I must have been about 10 years old. Second John Hedrick was named John Wesley, John W. And his son was James Hedrick. He's the one that I married. He was 7 years older than me.
What year did you get married?
Probably it was 1905. 1905, and Nelson, my son, was born in 1906, uh-huh. And Dorothy in 1908. Later, after my mother, Hedrick, died, we moved in with his father, John Hedrick. And then lived there, well, until after he died.
Your house had gas and electric?
Yes, it had. The lights were gas and electric. Remy's were the one that did the electrical wiring. Hedrick's owned, well, there were a number of gas wells, and John Hedrick owned one. And gas was supplied to part of the town from his well, which was on his farm just next to town.
The Welches were the same family that built the hotel.
Welches? Yes. It was a woman. Well, she was a widow, a wealthy widow, that built the hotel. She felt like we needed that hotel, and it was a fine place. It was a... Oh, anybody to stay. And some of the school teachers were from out of lived out of town, and while they were teaching school here, they lived at the hotel. And there were several people who lived in the hotel. Besides people that just came into Middletown for a short time and stayed there. Have the original wallpaper and the original carpet. The first Cadillac in Middletown, and built in 1913.
Was it the first automobile in Middletown?
No, my father had the first automobile, though.
That was a locomobile.
Well, that original one. And then he had other earlier automobiles, too.
One of the first cars in Henry County, wasn't it?
Yes, it was a steam. It was the only, that first locomobile was steam.
Yeah.
Yes, an unusual thing. In the corner, there's a curved place that has curved glass in the windows, which is about the only place in this town that ever had anything like that. And they were made at Muncie.
What room?
It was a living room.
And the bedroom upstairs?
Mm-hmm.
I give you all my love. The skies may fall, my love, and I will still be true.
John Hedrick had a farm, he owned all that out east there. And so had the barn, had a hay mow where he could keep his hay and farm material.
Hazel's husband, Jim, takes a ride as we saw his dad, John, with Dorothy and Nelson. In 1902, Charles Riley built this barn for John Hedrick on the southeast corner of Columbia and Fifth. Today, it is the Royal Apartments. This film was produced by Bob Hess in 1980.
This is Jim Hedrick and his mother in the kitchen. This is about 1910, showing the Hedrick house, which was located on the northwest corner of High and Fifth Street. It was built for John Hedrick II in 1899 by L.O. Miller. You can see electric wires running to it, which were attached shortly after it was built. The first electricity in Middletown was 1900. This is the new home right after it's finished. There's no shrubs around it, and the Hedrick family stands on the front porch. This is the Hedrick family out in the snow on High Street in front of their house, but in the background you can see the Wilhoyt house, and notice the barn and swing. We'll see the same barn in the next picture with John W. Hedrick sitting in a swing very similar to his neighbors. There you can see the barn in the background again across the street from High Street. The same barn that we just previously saw across the street, or High Street. This would be on the east or west side of the house. In the next scene, you will see on the left Wade Farrell real quick. As we pan from left to right, it's late. Wade Farrell, J.W. Hedrick, Hazel, Nora Pence, who's hard help, Nelson is in the baby chair, Jim Hedrick, Lily Hedrick, Walter Farrell, James D. Farrell, and Martha Farrell. Here we look at them again. There's the big swing that John was in with Nelson now with the ball. This is Eddie Minnick, one of the local neighbors on the front porch of the Hedrick house. You can see the screen doors on the front. Now we're looking north on Fifth Street toward the Hedrick barn, which was built one block north on Columbia Avenue and Fifth, the southeast corner. It was built by Charles Riley in 1902. This was about 1906. It's now the Royal Apartments. As you see another view of it, looking east from Fifth Street, you can see the sidewalk going up to the left on Columbia Avenue. Same building on the right in the background as Harold McMullen is standing there in the front as a young boy, and in the left background was the Dowie Hunter house, used to be Dr. DeGruy's house, and now you can see the barn as the Royal Apartments. This is about 1961, and then in October of 1986 the house went up on auction. We can see Susie Davis to the far right. In the red and white stripes. Charlie Harder was the auctioneer. Donnie Riggs helped him. Dr. Ihorn ended up buying most of the furniture as well as the home. Dora Maddox painted a picture of that picture we just saw. We see Rolan on the left. And then Dr. Ihorn started restoring the home. Put new copper around the eaves, guttering, and slate back on the roof. John W. Hedrick. Mrs. John Hedrick in the front room next to the fireplace. Doc and Vera Ihorn in 1989 after they finished their restoration. They took paint chips and came to the conclusion that was the original colors. It has a gray trim around the windows. later that year, in 89, in October the 19th, we had a unusual snow. The leaves are still on the ground, on the trees. A lot of power failures due to the weight of the snow on the leaves. October the 19th, 1989. Later at Christmas time, Ihorns had it all lit up. This is Mrs. Clarence Saylor. She's on Columbia Avenue. You can see the concrete sidewalk in the background. We're looking south. That's the large house in the background would be the Hedrick House, a block north, or a block south on High Street. You can see all the empty yards between here and there at that time. And here we see John Hedrick the second on the left. And that's all the pictures we have.